NetSuite has an abundance of ways to edit or update records depending on what will best meet each user's needs. For major updates, a CSV import or mass update would be appropriate. For smaller scale changes to a few records, you might just open and edit each record individually. But even for fewer records, this can be time consuming. This is where the NetSuite Inline Editing feature comes in handy. Let's take a look at this feature and how it works. To use Inline Editing, first, you need to turn on the Inline Editing feature, which you can do under the Company subtab of Enable Features. When this feature is turned on, then you can edit certain fields on record lists. For example, suppose you want to edit some fields on employee records. Navigate to the list of employees, list, employees, employees. On this list, select Edit at the top. Once editing has been turned on for this list, you'll see a pencil icon next to all the columns that can be edited. Notice, however, that only certain fields can be edited. In the list of employees, the editable fields include the employee's name, job title, and supervisor. To edit other employee fields, you would need to open the records. To make an edit, click into the field on the record row that you wish to change. Then, type in the new value for that field and click outside of the field to save your changes. If for some reason you are not able to edit these fields, then you do not have editing permission for these records and would need to contact your NetSuite administrator. In addition to its basic functionality, inline editing has some other helpful tools. First, if you realize that you made a mistake and would like to return a field to its original value, you can do that by selecting Ctrl-Z. And of course, if you make a series of mistakes in a row and need to access the original values for multiple fields, you can always find that information on the System Notes tab on each employee record. With inline editing, you can also edit multiple records from the record list page. To do that, hold the Control key and select the fields you need to edit. These fields all have to be in the same column on the record list, and their new values would be identical. What if you want to add a few new records quickly? Some record types allow you to do this on the record list when inline editing has been turned on. For records that allow you to do this, there will be an Add button at the top of the list. Selecting this button will open a pop-up window where you can put in the essential information that is needed to create that type of record. And finally, when inline editing is turned on, you can also add related records to a record in the record list. For example, you may want to create an email to one of your employees or add an expense report. To the far left on the record list, you'll see a column titled New. To add related records to one of the records in the list, hover over the new column in that records row and select the correct new record type from the dropdown. The inline editing feature allows you to be efficient with your time as you keep up with your ever-changing business needs.
Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, let us know by hitting the like button. And to learn more about how SuiteRep can help you with all of your NetSuite needs, visit us at SuiteRep.com.